I'm Steve with Easton Archery. In this video, we're going to show you how to install components into your target arrows. This installation process will work for any of our aluminum or aluminum carbon arrows, such as a Pro Comp, ACE, or our X10 series of arrows. The first component we're going to install in the arrow are the points. Now to do that, you'll need your points, you'll need some hot melt, a set of pliers, and the torch. A rule of thumb I like to follow is that while I'm going through this process, I should be able to hold the point in my hands. If it's become too hot to where I can't hold it in my fingers, then it's probably too hot to go into the arrow. And if you do this right, you'll have no issue. So the first thing to do is get your torch started. You don't need a ton of flame. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take the point and just quickly take it in and out of the flame. That helps clean off any of the oils that may have gotten themselves on the shank of the point. Next step is heat up our hot melt. We want to get this hot enough to where it easily transfers onto the point. Again, make sure we're using plenty of hot melt. Can't use too much. We can take our time doing this. Get a little more heat onto the hot melt. I like to put a dab of it just over the end of the arrow shaft and then start twisting it in. Okay, we're stuck. Get a little more heat. Another push. A little more heat. We're good. And we want to get that hot melt off the end. Easy as that. From an aluminum arrow, it's the same process. I'm gonna take my point, in and out of the flame, get myself some hot melt here. Again, plenty of hot melt on the shank of the point. Notice I've got the point in my hand the whole time. No issue there. Right there, I just get a little dab of it on the end of the arrow. With aluminum, you can actually get the arrow in the flame just a bit. Don't want to overheat it, but it's not as critical as on the carbon. And we're done. And when you're doing your bushings or pin bushings, such as on those Pro Comps, you would do it with the exact same process. You need very little glue to get those to hold. And again, you want to make sure you don't overheat any of those components or overheat the arrow, especially on arrows that have carbon in them. Lastly, we're going to show how to install a nock into a bushing. This is an Easton X2315, very common arrow used worldwide. This has a 6.5 millimeter bushing, formerly known as an S bushing, and this is our Super 3D nock, a 6.5 millimeter nock. When installing these, you'll want to have a nock wrench. These come in the bags of nocks. For installing nocks, I like to use a little bit of bowstring wax on the shank of the nock. This allows the nock to go into the bushing easier and also allows you to adjust the rotation a lot easier. So we just need a small bit of wax on the shank. Get it started, then I use a nock wrench to finish the job. Then I just figure out exactly where I'm going to index that nock, and we're done. The beauty of the bowstring wax is it makes it very easy to spin your nock to the next position should you need to adjust it. And that's how you install components into target arrows. For more info, check out the links in the description or visit eastonarchery.com.